Okay, yeah, so in the previous two videos, we did an example of how to create a pointer table in Microsoft Access for data where we only have two fields, right? So this video is the more complicated situation where you have many fields, right? So we'll start off with this Excel file here. So let's suppose that you have a small video rental business, right? So you have your Excel file in your PC, and every time a customer rents a movie, you say to them, what's your name? And they say, Jerry Ryan. And they say, can I have your address? And so they say 23 Main Street. And then they say, can I have your phone number? And you say 416-566-0000, whatever, right? And then you see what movie they're renting. So suppose they're renting a Star Trek Voyager. Okay, let's suppose, because we've already done that one, right? Let's suppose they're renting a Thunderbolt and Lightfoot. And the movie rating is 1 star. And they're renting it on April the 22nd, 2014, right? So you get the idea, right? Every day, or every time someone rents a movie, you're going to enter a new line in here, right? In an Excel file. And the whole problem with this method of doing it is that it is not normalized data, right? So if the same person comes in tomorrow, then you might spell their name differently, right? They might give you a phony address because they don't like people asking them what their address is, right? You might make a typo when you're typing their phone number. You might even make a typo when you're typing in the name of the movie, right? Like this. You might make a mistake with the rating, right? And you might even type the date incorrectly, right? Okay, so that's why you should not use this kind of system. You should use a normalized database, right? So when you have this kind of information, right, first of all, right, it requires a pointer situation, pointer table, because you've got movies and you've got information about movies, you've got persons and you've got information about persons, and it is a many-to-many relationship. In other words, one person can rent many movies, and one movie can be rented by many persons, right? So actually, the first thing you should do is sit down on a piece of paper and design your database so that you understand like what has to go where, right? You're gonna have to decide like what tables you're gonna have and what fields are gonna be in those tables, right? That might take you a long time. It's not going to take me a long time because I already know what I'm going to do, right? But you would have a customer table, right, that would have the customer information, such as the name, what we call the tombstone data, which is the name, address, phone number, all of the stuff that is related to the customer, right? You would have your movie table. It has all the information about the movie, like the title of the movie, the year the movie was made, the rating of the movie, and so on, right? And you would have your pointer table, right? That's the table that connects the other two tables together, right? Because it's a many-to-many relationship, right? And on top of this table would also have information about the actual connection. For example, the rental date, right? The rental date would be in the pointer table. because the same person might actually rent the same movie more than once on different dates, right? Okay, so now we have this Excel file, and I've saved it into an Excel file called Book 3. So if you're going to put that into an Access database, right, similar to what we did before. So we create a new Access database, blank database, and we'll call it Pointer 3. Right, and click on the Create button. We don't need this table, right? So like in terms of methodology, you can do this in slightly different ways. You can pull in all of the information from the Excel file first, and then you can split it up into different tables. Or you can split it up into different tables first and then import each table individually, right? I'm going to do it the first way. Okay, I'm going to import the table. There's the fields. The first row contains the column headings. The field names are okay. Okay, the first field is customer. Duplicates are okay. Second field is address. We don't need to index on that field. Third field is phone number. We can make that a text field, right? Fourth field is movie, text field, rating, and rental date. Okay, that's going to be a date field. Okay, let's also index on the movie name, right? You could even index on the rental date. Duplicate's okay. It's not a matter of great importance one way or the other in this case. Right? Okay, we're going to have a primary key, which is just the auto number kind of field. Okay, and we'll import it into a table called pointer 3. Right? Or even better, let's call it import. Right? Because that way we know it's the table that we're importing. Okay, finish. There's the table. Right? There's all the information. We didn't get any error messages, so we're lucky. Okay. There's all the information. Now we have to put it into the proper format, right? Which is this format here. Right? So I'll close the table. Right? So the same kind of thing. I'm going to make a table of customers. Right? So create query with the query wizard, right? And that field will have the customer, and then the fields that are associated with the customer. Customer's address, customer's phone number, not the other fields, because the other fields are not related to the customer, right? What title do you want for this query? I'm going to go, like, skip a step here for the sake of time. I'm just going to call this MAK customers. Right, make customers. Okay, so here's our field. Sorry, here's our file. There are the fields. Let's first of all sort it ascending. Second of all, let's group by customer and see the another thing is, okay, when you do this, you should look at the information, and if you notice that the same person has two different addresses, then you should, you know, either find out, did he make a mistake? Did he lie to me? Did he move? Right? Is it like two people that have the same name? Whatever, whatever. Right? Okay. In this case, since obviously I cannot phone these people and ask them what their real address is, I'll skip that, right? So well, let's just assume that in this case, there are two people named Bing Crosby, and they live at different addresses. Okay, so we're grouping by address, we're grouping by phone number, right? We could also sort. Now we're going to make a table of customers, right? So make table, and what's it going to be called? It's going to be called TBL customers, right? Okay, so I'll run this, You're about to paste 32 rows. There's the table. Close the query. Here's the table, right? So now we have a list of customers. Right, now we're going to go here. Design view. We're going to add a field called customer ID. Let's make it an auto number field. Let's put it at the top. Let's make it the primary key. Let's take a look at it. Right, so now we have customer ID for every customer, right? And if there's three people named Bolo Young who live at three different addresses, then they have different customer IDs, and that's how you tell the difference. Okay. Now similarly, we'll go to the import table again. We'll make a table of movies, right? So here we are at the import table. Create. Query with a query wizard. Again, to save time, I'll skip a step and I won't make a base query. Okay, we want movie. We don't want rental date. We want the movie and the rating, right? Right. So like I say, normally I make a base query just to save time. I won't make a base query. I'll just make a make table query. Make and the name of the file will be movies, right? Here it is. So there's only two fields related to movies. There's a movie name and there's the rating, right? We'll sort by movie, ascending, and we'll see there. Then we want to group, so click on the sigma, right? Okay, now at this point in time, if you see more than one record for the same movie, but the rating is different, then you know you've made a mistake, right? Unless there happen to be two movies with the same name. That does happen sometimes, right? But in our case, we don't have any problems, so we're okay. If we did have that problem, again, you would have to investigate, are there two movies with the same name? Did somebody make a typing mistake, right? Okay, so we got the data here. We're going to make a table. Click on Make Table. What's the name of the table? Name of the table will be TBL Movies. Okay. There we are. Now we run the query. You're about to paste 11 rows. That's fine. Close the query. Here's the table. Take a look at it. And it looks okay. Right click on the tab. Go to the blue triangle for design. Make a primary key called a movie ID. Should be an auto number. Click on the gray square, move it to the top, set it to be the primary key, take a look at the data. There we are, okay. This, move it over to the left. So primary key should always be the first field. It's easier to find that way. Now you notice there's a spelling mistake there. Right, so remember that, right, because we'll fix that. We won't fix it now, but we'll fix it later. Yeah. Okay, so now we have our table of customers, and we have a table of movies, right? Now we need to create our pointer table, right? The pointer table will be something like our import table, but it will have the ID fields instead of the names, right? So let's start by going to our import table. Let's make a query on that and take all the fields, right? And we'll call this QRY import. QRY import. Right, there's all the fields. We can see them, right? Now, we don't have the customer ID and we don't have the movie ID. We have to get those. So let's go to show table and add that table of customers and add the table of movies, right? Okay, let's first do movies by itself because it's movies is easier to understand. You got a movie name, right? Let's assume for the sake of simplicity that you don't have two movies with the same name, okay? If that's the case, then you can link from movie to movie name to movie name, right? make sure it's a join type to include all the records from the primary table. Right. We want to know the movie ID. Okay, we might want to know that rating. We might or might not, but since we got it there, let's put it in there. Right. So now let's look at the data to see if it looks correct. Right. Here's our import rating. There's our movie ID. There's a movie rating there. The reason why it's doing this is because there's two fields with the field name of rating, right? So that's why it puts that dot thing in there, table dot field name. Okay, what we're interested in, excuse me, is the movie ID, right? The movie ID should match the movie name. It should be the correct movie ID for the specified name, right? Okay, so we have that there, right? So now we can go to design. Let's save this, right? Now we can connect the table of customers, right? So I'm clicking on the yellow plus sign for add a table, right? Now, customers is a little bit more complicated because you could have two customers with the same name, right? You could have like two customers named John Doe. So if every customer had their own name, you could link from customer name to customer name like this, right? And make it a join type too. But since two customers can have the same name, this won't always work, right? So you should link on address also, because two customers would have the same name, but they would have different addresses, right? And if you wanted to be really sure, right, you could link on the phone number too, right? Because you can have like two customers such as John Smith Sr. and John Smith Jr. that live in the same house, but maybe one of them has a cell phone, right? So the phone numbers are different. So to be like really sure, you would do it that way, okay? And then you have your customer ID. You've already the customer name, the address, and the phone number, right? So if you look at the data here, right, what you want to check is that the customer name here in the import file is the same as the customer number here in the table of customers, right? Let's just make these other fields really small temporarily so that we can compare to see whether the customer names are the same, right? I'm making them small now. Okay, so now we see Bill Wallace, Bolo Young, Chuck Norris. If this was a business system, you would check every single one of them, but since this is just a test, I won't do that. Okay, so we're assuming now it's correct, right? So now we can make a new table, right, which will be our pointer table. So go to design, save this, right? Okay, I'm going to make a table. And what's it going to be called? It's going to be called TBL pointer 3. And I'll click OK. Right. And then I'll click Run. Resultant table not allowed to have more than one auto number field. Well, that's fine because I don't need more than one auto number field. Right. I don't need this field here, so I can just delete it. Right. I'm going to run it. It's again complaining about that. Right. That's because we've got the movie ID and the customer ID, and they're both auto number fields, right? So let's close this. That's kind of an annoying thing. Let's go to the table of customers, design, and change this from auto number to just number. Okay, now let's go back to our query import. You're about to run a make table query that will modify data. Okay, we hit the make table button, right? That's why it's saying that. So to avoid confusion here, let's go to design, right? Let's change it back to a select query. Or it's a select query, right? It's a select query, we look at it, we see the data that we've selected. Okay, now let's create a make table query. Create query with a query wizard. We'll take these fields and we'll call it MAK pointer 3. Right, that's makes it more clear what's going on. Right. And we're going to click on the make table button and we're going to make a table called TBL pointer 3. Right. Some of these fields we don't need in our new table, right? We don't need the customer name because we have the customer ID. The value should not be in more than one place. We don't need the address because the address is in the customer table. We don't need the phone number because the phone number is in the customer table. Likewise, the movie name. Likewise, the rating. We do need the rental date. We do need the movie ID. We don't need the rating. We do need the customer ID. We don't need the customer name. We don't need the customer address. We don't need the customer phone number, right? These are the two important fields here. Those are the two fields that connect to the other two tables, right? You connect to the customer via the customer ID. You connect to the movie via the movie ID, right? Rental date is kind of a third field, right? It just shows you what date the movie was rented. Right. Okay, so let's run this query. You're about to paste 42 rows. Yes. And here's our table of pointers, right? And there is the table of pointers, right? Which is what we wanted in the first place, right? And just to prove to you that it works correctly, let's create a query based on that table. By the way, before I do that, notice in the design of this table that there is no primary key. Every table should have a primary key. So let's say this is really a record of transactions, right? Because every transaction is this number, right? So that should be the primary key, right? So let's take a look at it. Access will automatically number them. Let's send that message. You have to take the auto number off of the other field. Right. Did you see that message? It's doing that just to annoy me, right? So I'm going to delete this field. Right? I'm going to look at the data. You have to do this in order to save the data, right? Then you have to add the transaction ID auto number field. And you have to make it the primary key and move it to the top. Like this, right? So every time the user enters the store and rents a movie, you will go to your access database and you will add a new record in here, right? So the next record will be record number 43, right? That's the auto number field, right? You remember I changed this to take off the auto number here. Now I can put it back. I can try to put it back in. Once you enter the scene, it won't let me do that. That's because we had to remove the auto number property. So when you add a new customer here, you have to type it in yourself. I'm sorry to say that. But in a way it's better, right? Because it gives you more control. I'm just doing that to demonstrate it to you, right? We're going to make a query to show the data in the table of pointers. Query wizard. all the fields, including the transaction ID, right? We will call it QRY pointer 3. Okay, and here is the data. That's the data that's in the table. But again, like in the previous video, you'd probably want to know the name of the customer, and you would probably want to know the name of the movie, right? So you would probably do this and make it a join type 2, and then add the movie name here, and add the rating, and add the customer name. So here's the rating, put the rating beside the movie, right? You got the customer ID, put the customer name beside the customer ID. Yeah, maybe you can put the rental date there beside the transaction ID. It kind of makes more sense that way, right? So here's our last record, right? Okay, remember that movie name was not spelled correctly. So let's go to the table of movies. Let's fix that spelling mistake. Let me close this and go back to our table of pointers. Sorry, let's go back to the query of pointers. Right, go to the last record. And now it's got the correct value, right? So now, and now you also notice that the date was not entered correctly, so you can change it here, right? So now the customer walks into the store, you would have a form, right? You would have a form based on this query, but for the sake of time, I'll pretend that this is a form. So the customer walks into the store, and it is April the 29th, 2014, and he rents a movie, and you've pasted a sticker on every movie saying what the movie number is, and it's number 5, so you don't have to type Rush Hour because it just pulls it up automatically. You don't have to type the rating because you've got that in your movie table, right? And you say, what's your customer number? Can I have your customer card? And he gives you his customer card, and it is number 20, right? So you know he's Jackie Chan. You don't have to ask him what his address is. You don't have to ask him what his phone number is. That annoys people anyways. So that's how you do it. So that's how you make a pointer table with the other associated information. And the original question was, can you auto-populate the table, right? Well, you can auto-populate it in the sense of you can take the original file that you have in Excel and you can import it into the database. Like, that's what I did there, right? And like I say, you can either import all the fields and then split it up into different files, right? Or you could split it up. See, the other way of doing it would be to split it up into 3 different Excel files, and then right, and then you could import the customer Excel file into the customer table in Access. Then you would import the movie Excel file into the movie table in Access, and then you could import the pointer Excel file into the pointer table in Access. I think that way would be more complicated, right? That's not the way I would do it, right? That's the way, that's why I did it this way, right? Which is to take the whole import file, right? And after you do that, you should take that Excel file and never use it again, right? Because like I say, that it's just a lot more cumbersome to hold information in Excel because there's nothing in Excel to prevent you from making a spelling mistake or a typing mistake, or, you know, 2 people could have different names. Like, it could be Smith with an E on the end, or Smith without an E on the end, right? So anyways, I hope that answers the question, and it's been a long video, so thanks for watching.